In a sign of how bizarre British politics has become, Boris Johnson is goading his opponents to bring down his government in the hope of securing a snap election. But they're not budging, saying he won't get an election until another Brexit delay has been granted by the European Union. Now, we'll cross live to London in a moment, but first this report on the extraordinary scenes in Britain's Parliament, which one MP called a horrendous spectacle.
He's still in control, Prime Minister.
He didn't want to be back here.
Did you get it wrong, Prime Minister?
But 11 Supreme Court judges found his prorogation of Parliament was unlawful. And so Boris Johnson returned to the House of Commons, as did the rest of Britain's MPs.
Welcome back to our place of work.
Despite calls from across the floor, the Prime Minister didn't apologise.
It is absolutely no disrespect to the judiciary to say I think the court was wrong to pronounce on what is essentially a political question.
Downing Street wants an election as soon as possible, leading to this extraordinary offer.
They have until the House rises today to table a motion of no confidence in the government.
Thanks, but no thanks, say opposition parties, who are worried an election called now would allow the Prime Minister to wriggle out of a law requiring him to ask the European Union for another Brexit delay.
He says he wants a general election. I want a general election. It's very simple. If you want an election, if he wants an election, get an extension and let's have an election.
While Mr. Johnson still has the backing of Tory MPs, he is in a difficult position with few options. Without a majority in the House of Commons, Boris Johnson will continue to be a punching bag in Parliament. He'll be unable to pass any meaningful legislation. He is essentially a zombie Prime Minister. And for now, that's the position his opponents want him to be in. Future sessions are unlikely to be as fiery as this one, however.
With many of us in this place subject to death threats and abuse every single day. And let me tell the Prime Minister that they often quote his words, surrender act, betrayal, traitor, and I for one am sick of it.
I have to say, Mr. Speaker, I've never heard such humbug in all my life.
During the Brexit referendum campaign, Remain-supporting MP Joe Cox was assassinated by a far-right nationalist. The MP who replaced her asked the Prime Minister this.
In all honesty, for as a human being, please, please, will he, going forward, moderate his language so that we will all feel secure when we're going about our jobs?
Can I say the best way to honour the memory of Joe Cox and indeed the best way to bring this country together would be, I think, to get Brexit done. And I absolutely do.
Parliament has resumed, but it's unlikely anyone in the House would think this was its finest day.
And SBS Europe correspondent Ben Lewis joins us again, this time live from London. Ben, tell us about Boris Johnson. He's come under further criticism for those comments about Joe Cox.
Yeah, Mike, good evening. That is right. And I just want to bring your attention to a tweet from Joe Cox's widower, Brendan Cox. He said, "Feel a bit sick at Joe's name being used in this way. The best way to honour Joe is for all of us, no matter our views, to stand up for what we believe in, passionately and with determination, but never to demonise the other side and always hold on to what we have in common." This discussion about inflammatory language, terming things as the surrender bill, accusing MPs of betraying the public is likely to be a key talking point in the coming days, but it is overshadowing the fact that Boris Johnson politically at the moment is in a very difficult position. Last night, in response to a question from an opposition MP, he said that he would not be asking the European Union for another delay to Brexit, despite the fact a law has been passed demanding that he has to. So he has a couple of options. He can either go back on his word or he could defy the law. And if that happens, Mike, we might be back in the Supreme Court sooner than expected.
Unbelievable. Thanks, Ben, for the update. That's Ben Lewis reporting from London.